Hey guys, so this is gonna be an explanation about our exam for the ones who missed the explanation in class, or you don't remember, or you have some doubts. Here you have the explanation. No need to write your name here. Absolutely no need. Each and every one of you gets a copy of this document with your name on it. So no need to write your name. You're gonna submit your final exam to Google Classroom, and again I will receive your name, right? So absolutely no need to write your name in this space. Everything else is more or less the same as a usual exam, although this one is a home exam. But let's start with what you already know. This part is the self-evaluation part, and we have here four statements, four criteria. And what I want you guys to do is to give yourself a grade for each one of those. So for the first criteria, you're going to write number 1. And then you're going to give yourself a grade from 10, the best, to 1, the worst. First criteria is the disposition towards learning. How willing were you to learn? Did you come to class every day with the best attitudes towards learning? You try to maximize your learning opportunities. If this is you, give yourself a 10. If, on the contrary, you were passive, didn't take advantage of the learning opportunities, had excuses instead of successes or attempts for success, you give yourself a 1. If you were somewhere in the middle, sometimes you did one, other times you did the other, somewhere between 2 to 9. For the second criteria, helping others, if you help others always, all times, you give yourself a 10. Never helped anyone, give yourself a 1, somewhere in between 2 to 9. Third criteria, respect for others. If you always respect everyone in every way, give yourself a 10. If 3 of your friends can say that you were repeatedly disrespectful towards them, give yourself a 1. And if you are somewhere between 2 to 9, you write your answers in this document. It is automatically saved, as you can see. No problem. You can work on it as many times as you like until the due date. Last criteria in the self-evaluation is self-respect. Not respect towards others, respect for yourself. If you looked at yourself as a valuable person, a capable person, a one that can solve its own problems, and this is exactly what you did, you give yourself a 10. If, on the other hand, you looked at yourself as an incapable person, someone that can help himself, invaluable, can't do anything, you give yourself a 1. If you're somewhere between 2 to 9. Okay? Good. So this is the part of the self-evaluation. I'm going to erase this. Let's move to the instructions of the exam. This exam, the purpose of this exam, is to evaluate your knowledge and skills that we acquired during this bimester. What's different about this exam is that it's a home exam. You do it at home. Don't come to class, lock you in the room, and you write your exam in 2 or less hours. Take the time you need. You have until the 8th of September at 9 p.m. That's Thursday. At 9 p.m. at night. Can do the exam whenever you want. You can open it, close it, do it as many times as you like, right? Do it at home at the time that you have. As a home exam, you are very welcome to use all sources of information available to you. You can talk to your friends, talk to your family, your favorite rabbi, your priest, your pastor, your neighbors, your secretary, whomever, the internet. Feel free to use all the sources of information available to you, but do not copy-paste. If you talk to your friend, you ask them, hey, what do you think about the first question, and so on. That's fine. That's perfectly fine. Do not write the answer. Don't even write something close to the answer. Write your own question, your own answers. You can discuss the topic, discuss the questions, but make sure that your work is original. I'm going to use an application that looks for similarities. There is no way to fool this program. Absolutely no way. It is used in all the leading universities. Please, don't test us, right? Make sure your work is original. And again, you're very welcome to discuss ideas, to ask questions about the questions, to talk about the topics, right? Don't copy answers. Again, please submit your answers, the home exam, to Google Classroom, only to Google Classroom, not to my mail, not to anywhere else, not on paper, to Google Classroom by the 8th of September. Because you have more than a week to do that, there are no excuses about internet failures or whatever. Just do it until the deadline. Every question will be graded according to a grading rubric. That means the criteria with which I evaluate your answers are already determined. I don't decide them after I see your answers. They are already decided and they are transparent to you. I give them to you right now. So let's go over the questions and then I'm going to show you for each question how I'm going to evaluate it. Let's go over the questions. Every question starts with a statement. This statement gives you the context, should focus you on the on the topic of the question, right? What I'm asking you to do in the first question is to describe and explain the most important choice in this story. In this story, the most important choice has to do with the hierarchy of values, which value is more important than other. These characters are making many choices, are taking many choices, right? These choices are always within values. One of these choices clearly shows, or shows in a clearer way than others, which value is more important than any other. Please explain, in your opinion, which is the most important choice and why. Of course, your explanation must show that it has to do with values. This is the rubric. This is how I'm going to grade the first question. Question number one. The answer is worth a maximum of 2 points. 1 point goes for the values. The other one goes for the mechanics. How do you write in English? Let's start with the mechanics. 1 point, a complete 1 point, 100% of it, goes to you if you have only few or none mistakes in English grammar. It's okay to have a few mistakes, right? But it's not okay to have spelling mistakes because you write your answer in the computer and it auto-corrects it. It highlights your mistakes in spelling and suggests a correction. If you want to get the 100%, don't make mistakes in spelling. It's okay to make one or two mistakes in English grammar. It's fine. If you have 3 to 7 mistakes in grammar, you are here. Or 1 to 5 spelling mistakes, you are here. Get 75% of this 1 point. If you have plenty mistakes, more than 7 in grammar, you are automatically here. And if you have more than 5 spelling mistakes, even though you're using the computer and it auto-corrects it and it annoys me, you get 0.5 point that reserves for the mechanics. This one is not for you, it exists, but you guys want to make sure that you are here. You understand what's the difference between the best, good, acceptable, bad. You want to be here. This is the pastel, this is the machete, this is how you get the best answer. This is the recipe for the best kind of answer. When I'm gonna grade you, I'm gonna highlight where your answer is at. If in the values category, in the first question, you are here, the values that demonstrated through the choice that you are explaining is undisputedly the most important ones in the story, you're here, I'm going to highlight it in green. I'm going to have you go, you know that you got 1 point for it, right? If in another situation, the values that are demonstrated through the choice that you are explaining are among the five most important, but they are not undoubtedly, undisputably the two most important, you get 75%. Now, I want you to make sure that I understand that these are the most important. Your explanation is very important here, right? Pay attention, I didn't say how long your answer should be, but this basically gives you the notion that you need to persuade me, right?
If I can make a mistake and say they are undisputably the most important,
but they might be from the five most important, so the lines that you saved here gonna cost you here. If the values that you demonstrate through the choice are evident in the story, they exist in the story, but they are not among the most important, you'll get half a point, and this one is not for you. Second question is about the story Tanuro Shel Achnai. Here, there is a statement that should remind you and focus you, give you the right context to answer these two questions. I want you to please this explain, according to the story, how the meaning of the law is being decided in the Jewish culture. This story starts with an argument about a law that has to do with purity and impurity. But what it really is about, what this story is really about, is this technique, this mechanism of deciding the meaning, the right meaning of a law. And this is what they are arguing. They show more than one way, at the end, they show which is the right way according to Judaism. I want you to describe that. How does the Jewish culture decide the meaning of a law? Then I want you to please write an original story, your own story, about a society with no rules at all, absolutely no rule, not a single one. Show what happens by describing specific cases from everyday life, right? Choose whatever you like. A person goes to the store, right? Whatever. Show what happens when there are no rules at all. Let me show you how I'm gonna grade it. Here is the second question. The rubric for the second question. It is worth 6 points, the complete answer is worth a maximum of 6 points. This is how you're going to be graded. If you talk about the way of interpretation, the meaning of the law, and you show more than one way, and it is described in a very good way, perfect, you got it, 100%. If the way of interpretation of the law is being determined, if the way the interpretation of the law is being determined is described accurately using quotes from different parts in the story, good. What is the difference? Here, the way the interpretation of the meaning of the law is being described accurately using quotes from different parts in the story, and let me show you the rubric of the second question. The entire answer is worth 6 points, and this is how they will be given. 3 points will be given to how you talk about the laws. You will get 100 points if the way, the interpretation, the meaning of the law is being determined, if it is described accurately using quotes from different parts in the story, and confronting the right way of interpretation with the other way, you get 100 points. That means you will use quotes, you will explain the right way of interpretation according to Judaism, but you're gonna show that there is a possible other way, but it is the incorrect, and you're gonna use quotes from the story to prove your point. If you show two ways, then you show which one is the right one, perfect, 100%, 3 points. If you show the right interpretation and use quotes from different parts of the story to support the right way, but there's only the right way, there is no the wrong way, there is no alternative in your answer, that's okay. You get 75% for that. So I will define percent from 3 points. If you describe the right way of interpretation of the law according to Jewish culture, but there are no quotes and no alternative, you get a point and a half. Explanation is wrong, not for you. In the story, if the description of the society with no rules is vivid, you show three or more individual different symbolic incidents, cases that demonstrate how does it look, a society with no rules, good or bad, don't care if the society is good or bad, it's fun to live in or it's not, I just want to know how it looks like according to you. I want to know it. I don't want you to explain to me. I want you to show it to me through three different individual symbolic incidents that happens in such a society. If you show it through two individual different symbolic incidents, you're here. Only one, nothing. Story is creative, original, pleasurable, you're here. Not original, still creative, focused and pleasurable. It is focused, you're here. Mistakes in English, no need for mistakes in spelling. I'm talking about few mistakes in grammar, that's okay. No mistakes in English, you're here. Some mistakes in grammar, some few mistakes in spelling, you're here, and so on, right? This was the second question. Third and last question is about a story which is called Kamtsa, the Bar Kamtsa. It is a very, very known story. If you were here the previous years in school, I'm sure that you learned it. Anyways, we're going to learn it our next class, and there is already an activity and an explanation about it waiting for you in Google Classroom. This story is about the destruction of the temple in Jerusalem, the destruction of the house of God, the exile of the people of Israel. And this is a very, very severe punishment. My question is, why such a severe punishment? What did they do? What did the Jews do, in your opinion, to deserve such a horrible punishment? Why does God think that what they did is so bad? Which it takes us to the second one. What is the message that God wants to send? They are very related. If you want, you can answer it in one answer, right? You can say what are the reasons and what is the message that God wants to send. The rubric does qualifies it as one, right? I want to know what is the explanation. Sorry, I want to see that your explanation refers to values, at least two of them, and to the specific way they are understood in this culture. Not how you understand it, how they understood in this story and according to the story in the Jewish culture. I want your arguments to be supported by quotes. Don't say, well, I think that. I want you to say, I think that because you explain and you show in the text, you quote part of the text, and this is the reason I think that. Okay? You use at least two quotes that shows at least two values, and you explain them, you explain how these values are understood in the culture according to the story, using quotes from the story, perfect. All right, guys, at the end of this video, right about now, you should see a link to a forum. You just write your questions. I will go there. I will try to answer your questions. Your friends can answer your questions. That's about it. Feel free to ask questions also in Google Classroom. Don't forget to submit your exam until the due date. Only to Google Classroom. Please mark it as done. Thank you. Good luck.